Welcome students, in this video we are going to learn field effect transistor. Field effect transistor is a device where the flow of current is controlled by an electric field. So it is called field effect transistor. The current conduction here it is by only majority carriers, so it is called unipolar device. BJT, bipolar junction transistor, is a current control device, and here field effect transistor is a voltage control device. The field effect transistor is used in amplifier and switching circuit. It has two types: junction field effect transistor and metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. JFET has two types: N channel JFET and P channel JFET. This is the symbol and constructional diagram of JFET. This is N channel JFET and this is P channel JFET. Now we see the construction of the both JFETs. Okay, so this is the N channel JFET. It is made of an N-type semiconducting material which is called channel, which is this N-type material is sandwiched between P-type material. This P-type material is connected together to form the gate terminal, and the N-type channel, the both end brings two terminals, drain and source. Similarly, for the P-channel JFET, P-type material is access the channel. This P-type material is sandwiched between N-type material, and this N-type material is connected together to form the gate terminal. And the both end of the P-type material has two terminals, drain and source. The gate terminal will be highly doped material. And these are the symbols of N-channel JFET and P-channel JFET. Now we see about the operation of N-channel JFET. This is the circuit diagram for N-channel JFET. This is the voltage between gate and source, and this is the voltage between drain and source. To study the operation, we see one by one. First, we are going to consider the voltage across drain and source is zero, and voltage across gate and source is zero. When both voltages are zero, then there won't be any change in the JFET. The thickness of the depletion layer remains same. Next condition, when VDS is equal to zero, that is voltage across drain and source is zero, and VGS, voltage across gate and source, is decreased from zero. It is decreased from zero, that is PN junction or reverse biased. So here the gate terminal P is connected to negative terminal and N layer is connected to the positive terminal. Hence the thickness of the depletion layer will increase. See here, it in the first diagram it will be normal, and in the second, when we increase this, that is when we decrease this voltage, then the depletion layer width gets increased. After that, if you are continuously decrease the VGS value, the depletion layer width will get continuously increased, and one point the both layer will make a contact with each other. The voltage required, the VGS required to have this cutoff state is called cutoff voltage. Okay, this is the region, cutoff region. This is the drain characteristics. It is the curve drawn between drain current and drain source voltage at a constant gate source voltage. Okay, we see the each and every part of this curve one by one. Next condition, when VDS is equal to is increased from zero and VGS will kept at zero. Okay, next, VDS is increased and VGS is kept at zero. Now, the drain terminal is connected to the positive terminal and source is connected to the negative. So here the electrons in the N channel will attract towards the positive region, positive terminal. So the electrons move from source to drain. If electrons moves in this direction, the current flow will be in the opposite direction. So the current will flow from drain to source. If we increase the magnitude of the VDS, if we continuously increase this voltage across the drain and source, the depletion layer will increase and it forms a wedge shaped channel. Here we can see some of the important points that has to be noted. If we increase this value, VDS value continuously, the cross-sectional area of the channel will get reduced. So that what happens, the area nearer to the drain region will get minimum. So the voltage, at certain voltage, the area nearer the drain region will get minimum. That voltage is called pinch off voltage. Okay, at certain voltage, the cross sectional area in the drain region will get minimum. That voltage is called pinch off voltage. By increasing the VDC, we can see some points in drain characteristics. So by increasing, as the VDC is increased, the drain current also get increased, and it increase along the direction OP. This, after the it reaches this pinch of voltage, okay, this is VP. After it reaches the pinch of voltage, if we further increase the VDS, the ID current, drain current becomes constant. Okay, the why it is constant means here the region, okay, the pinch of region will further increase. So there won't be any current flow further, and it is constant for certain period. And after, at a certain point, the current suddenly increases due to the avalanche multiplication of electrons caused by breaking of covalent bond. Next condition is when VDC is increased and VGS is negative. So this is the circuit diagram. When the gate is maintained at the negative voltage, less than that of the cutoff voltage. Okay. So if we reduce the VGS value more negative, then it enters into the cutoff region. So we don't need that cutoff region. So we are going to maintain the value which is less than the cutoff region. The reverse voltage across the drain junction is further increased. This VDS value is further increased. Then the curve will be similar to the VGS is equal to 0. We will attain this curve. But the VP value, okay, pinch off voltage, and the breakdown value, okay, this is the breakdown region where we will get the sudden increase of current because of avalanche multiplication. This voltage, okay, this voltage VDGO, this value VP and VDGO value are lower. The drain current, this drain current is controlled by the electric field or electric field. So you can see from the graph here, in this active region, okay, this is the active region. In this active region, the drain current doesn't depends upon the VDS value. However, whatever the VDS value, the drain current is constant, and this drain current value depends only upon the voltage across the gate and source. So from this we can say that the drain current is controlled by the electric field that extends in the gate and source channel. So this device is called field effect transistor. These are the comparison between JFET and BJT. So we already know JFET is a unipolar device and BJT is a bipolar device. And here some of the difference. Okay, JFET, it conducts only by majority carriers, and BJT, here the conduction will be both by majority and minority carriers. It is the JFET is a voltage control device and BJT is a current control device. And here JFET, the noise level will be low, and here BJT, the noise level will be high, and it has high input impedance and BJT has low input impedance. And JFET, the gain is characterized by transconductance, and BJT, the gain is characterized by voltage gain. Here the thermal stability is better, and BJT, the thermal stability is very less. Okay. So go through the book, and if you are having any doubt, put it in the comment box. Thank you, students.